Good morning, friends. I am Purva, and today we will discuss the following question. Write two different vectors having same magnitude. Let us now begin with the solution. Let vector A is equal to I cap plus j cap minus k cap, and vector B is equal to I cap minus j cap plus k cap. So these are two different vectors. So now we will show that these two vectors have same magnitude. Now we have magnitude of vector A, that is mod of vector A is equal to under root of 1 square plus 1 square plus minus 1 square, and this is equal to under root of 1 plus 1 plus 1, and this is equal to under root 3. So we have got magnitude of vector A is equal to root 3. Now we will find magnitude of vector B. So magnitude of vector B, that is mod of vector B, is equal to under root of 1 square plus minus 1 square plus 1 square, and this is equal to under root of 1 plus 1 plus 1, and which is further equal to under root 3. So we have got magnitude of vector B is equal to root 3. So we have got magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B. So these are two different vectors having same magnitude. Now we will take another example of two different vectors having same magnitude. So again, let vector A is equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap minus k cap, and vector B is equal to I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Now we will find magnitude of vector A. So magnitude of vector A, that is mod of vector A, is equal to under root of 2 square plus 3 square plus minus 1 square, and this is equal to under root of 2 square is equal to 4, so we have 4 plus 3 square is equal to 9, so 9 plus and minus 1 square is equal to 1. And we get this is equal to under root 14. So we have got mod of vector A is equal to root 14. Now magnitude of vector B, that is mod of vector B, is equal to under root of 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, and this is equal to under root of 1 plus 4 plus 9, because 1 square gives 1, 2 square gives 4, and 3 square gives 9, and we get this is equal to under root 14. So we get mod of vector B is equal to root 14. So again we have seen that magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B. So similarly, like this, there are infinite number of solutions. Thus we write, there are an infinite number of possible answers. Hope you have understood the solution. Bye and take care.